Now, I've been a student of leadership all my life, and I've evolved that thinking over the years, and I've described it in different ways at different points in my career. And I've sort of formed a model now that I sat back and reflected after I retired from business. And this model sort of incorporates the many mistakes that I made, the bruising failures that I encountered. It reminds me of the leading winning teams that I was part of that achieved goals that many people thought were impossible. And it's from these life experiences that I've developed the model that I'd like to briefly share with you this morning. And it's a real simple model, and it's captured in three words. The first is character, the second is competency, and the third is commitment. Character, competency, and commitment. The common ingredients that I've seen in leaders that live lives of success and, more importantly, significance. Let's start with character. The single most important trait of a successful leader, and in my opinion, the failure of character. The failure of character is the most prevalent cause of business and personal failure. In its simplest forms, character means knowing right from wrong. A leader with the internal compass and under all circumstances can be expected in all situations to do the right thing. Well, most people would, I think, agree with that statement, but I'd say it's way too simple to think of character simply as honesty. It starts there, but it's much more complex. Character is based on a foundation of core beliefs, and for many, that foundation is anchored in personal faith and religion. But however it's anchored, my opinion is character has to be learned, it has to be practiced, and it has to be proven over time. And it's tested in what I call the crucible of life. Now, the second point is competency. I believe competency has two parts. One is knowledge, and the second is experience and wisdom. The first you'll certainly get here at Wake Forest if you apply yourself to the course of study. The second part, many of you brought with you in prior work experiences, but we all continue to learn. We all learn how to gain wisdom from the experiences of our business experience. We've all seen many failures in business, particularly over the last decade. I'd say over the last decade, there have been more prominent business failures probably than certainly any time in my business career. And many people believe that the majority of the cause for those failures was character. And certainly there was a fair amount of that. And that character failure gets the biggest press. But I would submit to you that the largest reason for failure over the last decade is not character, it's competency. And it's a lack of experience and a lack of a worldview in making important business decisions. We've certainly seen that in the financial industry. But we've also seen some very competent leaders emerge during the past few years. And these leaders can be distinguished by having strong character for sure, but I would say that they also have even stronger competency. These leaders had true competency. They married their intellectual capability and their creativity with experience and wisdom, and the result was great business results. The third trait of a successful leader is commitment. Commitment to do what it takes, but to do it the right way. It's the fire in the belly. It's the goal line orientation. It's the drive to reach results. You know, it's fun to work around committed leaders. They make things happen. You can feel the commitment of a committed leader just by being in their presence. And they come in lots of different forms and packages. The faculty and staff here at Wake Forest, in my opinion, are the best anywhere in doing what is so important for you as students. They're going to help you find that fire. They're going to ask you questions. They're going to test you. they're going to certainly equip you with all of the technical skills you need. And by all means, they're going to challenge you on your moral compass. But you know, at the end of the day, as good as the staff and faculty are here, they're only going to be as helpful to you as the efforts you put in to your own career. So you're the one that has to make it happen. And my dream is, as it has been for the last 3 years, that at graduation, that I'll see each one of you walk across that stage in front of your family and friends to receive the recognition for a rigorous education and the job of your dreams.